Floss Tube. This is Sandy. My channel is Stitching with Sandy. Hello, happy May Day. Today is May 1st, 2022, and it's Sunday night. I hope you all had a wonderful weekend, and I hope you're welcoming May as a wonderful month. It's my favorite month of all because it's my birthday month, but also I love spring, so it makes me really happy, and I can confirm that in California, spring has sprung because my allergies are just exploding. So since the last time I saw you, a few things have happened. Let's see. We had our Alba's women's dinner. That's all the Alba women in my husband's family, plus me, because I'm an Alba woman too. And we went out to dinner at a place called Pinnacle Peak, and it's a steakhouse. And it's amazing. That place, you can't dress up. It's no fancy there. You're supposed to, if you wear a tie, they will cut it off, and they make a big deal about it too. So we saw two ties being cut off, but we had a great time. We laughed. We get to catch up on what's going on. We took a group photo, and in our group photo, two men that were sitting at the end of the table next to us photobombed. So we were laughing when we saw the picture, but it was okay because later on they bought us all a round of Macintosh apple shots, I think is what it was called. So that was really nice of them. So then we took a group photo with them included, and we just laughed and had a great time. It's a wonderful time to get together with other family members like that because there's carefree, no stress, just want to have fun and break loose from the everyday life. So that was fun. Let's see. I had my stitchy night with my three close friends. We stitch every Thursday night, and this week I decided to surprise them and make them a project bag. I did make a few project bags that I'll share with you later, and at that time I'll show you because now we all are quadruplets, I think that's the word, because we all have matching bags, and I thought that was a lot of fun to be able to surprise them with a special gift just to let them know how much I appreciate their friendship. And then in kindergarten land, we are in the midst of rushing through all the last minute preparations for open house. Our caterpillars have grown big and fat and are now chrysalis. So we're hoping that they chew their way out of the chrysalis sometime this week, but not too soon, because we would like to have them in their butterfly enclosure for open house. So hopefully, fingers crossed, we'll still have them in time for open house. But if not, I will include some photos of us of our butterflies and then of us releasing them. That'll be a lot of fun. I'm also gonna share what my classroom will look like because it's gonna be amazing. We have been working really, really hard. So, let's see. Sorry, I'm just checking my notes, make sure I don't forget anything. I think that's it as far as updates. My birthday's next weekend. Next weekend is Mother's Day, so just in case I forget, I hope that every mom out there, no matter what kind of mom you are, you could be blood mom, adopted mom, stepmom, whatever mom you are. I wish you the happiest Mother's Day. You deserve it. Kick your feet up, make everyone serve you, and relax, do some stitching, whatever you want to do for the day, but just enjoy your day. And that's my birthday, so I will have a double dose of spoiling, hopefully. Fingers crossed again. I do want to do a couple of shout outs. A couple of people have shouted me out, and I would like to shout them out on my channel. And the first is a pair, a mom and daughter duo, and they're from Tennessee, and they're called Small Town Needleworks, and I will link them below so you can go check them out. They are Kim and Jade. Kim is the mom and Jade's the daughter. They do a lot of stitching, but they also do sewing and crochet. Kim's made some beautiful project bags. She's made some totes, so has Jade. And Kim just came out with a stitchy spot that she designed, and it's perfect for retreats. So if you don't have one and you're interested, make sure you go follow that link so you can find out about it at her Etsy shop. They're newer stitchers, so they're still in the under 1,000 subs like me. So make sure that you like them and subscribe. They could use our help, and so can I. So let's help each other out. Another person I'd like to share is the Starlet Stitcher. Her name is Tanya. And Tanya, she stitches a lot of Hades and samplers, and I'm amazed by how much she gets done. She is currently in, you see her YouTube channel comes straight to you from her RV, I believe, and it's because she's having her house built. And so I'm amazed at how she keeps everything organized and can do her stitching from there. She amazes me. I don't know how I would fit all of my stuff in an RV, so that gives her big props. So Tanya, you're a rock star. All right, so FFOs. I do have some FFOs to share today. I'm excited to share them with you. First of all, if you know, maybe you don't know, but in the beginning of this year, I decided to make a bucket list, and my bucket list has 12 projects of cross-stitch like projects of things that I've never tried but I've always wanted to. And since I'm a stitcher, you think most stitchers have done these, and I had not in all 30 years of my stitching career. So this year is the year to try them all. So I have been working. One of them was a scissors fob, and the one I chose to do was by, it's called Full Moon by the Drawn Thread, and here is the front. So here's my scissors. Here's the front. And then here is the back. And I'm so excited. It was not difficult. The only thing is I stitched this on evening blue dyed, Rit dyed Monaco 28 count. And in the corners were kind of thick. So trying to do the ladder stitch back and forth was really tough. I didn't like how the corners looked. I felt like they looked more bulky with the black thread. So I went ahead and put some black chenille on it to make it look a little bit prettier. So not bad for my first try. I'm sure the more I practice, maybe I can figure out a way to thin out the corners so that I won't have to cover it up. But I'm proud of myself because I tried it, I was successful, and now I can move on to the next bucket list project. All right, and another thing that I've never done before is I decided to join Helen D. She's another YouTuber. She is doing Stitch All the Berries Sal this year, and it's called, I think that's hashtag Season Sal. I'm not sure, but Berry Season Sal or Season Berry Sal. I will link it below. Whatever it is, I will link it below so that you can check on those hashtag and see everybody else's work. But I've only done the first berry in the spring set by Erica Michaels, and this is it. I'm so excited. So here, oops, let me start from this side. So here's the side. Spring has sprung. So excited. And here's my topper. And I owe all of the putting this together, thank you to Helen D. She has a tutorial both on how to sew the berry, how to stuff it, and then she also has a tutorial on the spring berry toppers, and she goes through each topper for all three berries, and there's no way I could have done it without her. She made the tutorial because Erica Michaels has a tutorial, but there are pictures and written instructions, so she decided to do a video, and I'm so grateful because I am a visual learner, and so by watching, I was able to create it, and I'm super proud of it. It's not difficult, everybody. It's not. I was amazed at how quickly it came together, and I'm looking forward to doing a lot more berries. So now I'm on Team Stitch All the Berries with Helen D. So thank you, Helen, for that. Then I'm also in a group that is stitching just cross stitch Christmas 2021 issue, ornament issue, and they pick out one ornament every month to stitch. I'm 1 month behind, well, half a month, I should say. My March one, I wasn't enjoying the stitch, to be honest. I was worried that it was kind of dull. It wasn't what I normally stitch. And then I started thinking, well, it doesn't matter because I can gift it to someone and they will love it because I made it. And it is cute, but it's just not my taste. So I went ahead and fully finished it. I made it into a tag, and it's by Needle Bling, and it's called Merry Christmas. So this is the one that I did. I'm very happy with it. I stitched it on 14 count Fabric Flare Magical Clouds is the fabric. And so I stitched it, and then I backed it. I just made a little tag. Finish, and here's the back, and added a cute little bell. So I think that'll make a nice gift for someone later in the year. One ornament down, who knows how many to go. And then my next FFO, and I literally finished this yesterday, just in time for the end of April. So it'll be displayed beautifully next year, but at least I can say I finished it. And it's the April Sampler of the Month by Country Cottage Needleworks. And here's my finish, trying to get the glare out of there. I'm very happy with how it turned out. Sorry, the glare just takes the whole picture. But it was funny because I was stitching it last night, and I think my husband thought it was silly that I was trying to get it done before today, because after all, it is for the month of April. It won't be displayed other than today in my house, but it's done. So project done is all that matters. It was fun too. So then my next one, I'm trying to get ready for the month of May, which is already here. I did change out my house into bees and sunflowers. I love sunflowers, my favorite flower. And I showed you this finish on my last video, but it wasn't fully finished. And it's Be Nice or Buzz Off by Primrose Cottage. And here's my fully finish. I love how it turned out. I found this little honeycomb fabric at Michael's, like in their fat quarters section. And then I stitched it on Berkshire Hive that has the little honeycombs along the fabric. And I love how it turned out. I was worried it might not, it might be difficult because you do stitch the little honeycombs here, and I thought it might clash, but it looks great. So I'm really happy with how it turned out. So this one's going in my house, yay. So I'll put this up after the video. And then, I'm also in another sal. This sal is a Year of Celebrations on Facebook by Hands on Design. And they did the Year of Celebrations, her first season. And I had joined the group, but I've only stitched one other piece from them, and it was the May from the old one. But when the new one came out at market, I had to have it because I think every single one of them is adorable. And since the month of May is my birthday, I started with that one. So here's my finish for May, Seasons 2 by Hands On Design. And there is that same fabric. I did this frame. I got it at Hobby Lobby at Christmas time. It is, it says Joy on the inside, but I magnetized it so that I could change it out every month. And I also magnetized the bow at the top. Oops, it's slipping, the bow at the top, there. So I could change it out. So this will sit proudly in my house for the month of May. And I'm very excited about it. So I hope you like it. And that will wrap up my FFOs. So I had a good time. I'm a little worried about next visit because we are starting Mania, and I've never done Mania before. So in a little bit, I will share with you what my plans are for Mania. That doesn't seem too out of control for me. So let's move on. We are at checking the notes, trying to stay organized. All right, giveaways. So my giveaways from last time, let me grab those. Oh, I don't want to do giveaways yet. I forgot my other things I did make. I made project bags. So this is one of them. And this is more of that fabric that I found at Michael's. They also had, or actually I think this one was at the dollar store, I think. And so I made a project bag, and I thought it went beautifully with the Primrose Cottage pieces. I'm stitching a few more. And I like that the colors match so nicely. So I was very excited to put that one together. Super excited. I wish they had had more bags, more fabric like this, because I would have bought more so I can make some for gifts, but they didn't have any. And then the one that I made for me and the three girls in my group, there's four of us. We all live in the same city and we're all stitchers, was this bag. And funny thing about this bag is this fabric, my daughters, I was their Girl Scout leader, and when they were daisies, I had purchased, I wanna say it was like 3 yards of this fabric, and sewed it into a tablecloth, so when we went to sell cookies, we could put it out for the cookie sales. Well, they are grown now, and they're not in Girl Scouts anymore, and as I was cleaning and putting some things away, I saw the fabric and thought, well, let's repurpose it. So I took it apart, and of course it's washed already. Washed it, took it apart, and then put it into a project bag for me and the three girls that I stitch with. And I did put some rickrack in there, and the inside is the same as the top. And so That was fun, and I was so happy to gift it to my friends, and I hope they love it. They said they did, so hopefully they weren't just being nice. And then the last one that I did was I had seen this tree fabric at Walmart and thought it was super cute, and so I wanted to put it together, and I had this, already had some of this pink in my stash of collected fabrics over the years. I had this tassel. I had made the tassel, if you remember from before, for Sarah, and I didn't have enough tassels to do my own. So I went to the store and I found some that matched this tree right here, and I thought this would be perfect, and then a purple zipper to match the purple tree because it's so bright and colorful. It makes me think of spring. So those are my project bags. So now I can get to the giveaways. Let me get those. And then also, I wanted to go over two of the giveaways from my floss tube before. And from number 14, they didn't claim them yet. So ladies, I'm gonna share again today. And if you don't claim them by my next floss tube in 2 weeks, then I'm going to pick another winner. So one of them was Samplings by Brenda Gervais. This is just the pattern. I don't have the fabric for the two eggs, and because I already stitched it, and so I don't have the fabric, but it is the pattern. And the winner of that was, her YouTube handle is LadyLegionnaire13, and I believe she signed her name as Linda. So Linda, this is yours. So if you will email me, my email address is in the description box below. Please be careful, everyone. My name email is sandyalba8@gmail.com. A lot of people forget the number 8, so don't forget 8, so that I can get your address and get this out to you. And the other person that was a winner of Little House Needleworks ABCs, and this was the spring ABCs, and the winner of that was... Oh, I'm sorry. So sorry, I made a huge mistake. This one is for Cindy Francis. And this one is for Lady Legionnaire 13, Linda. Linda, I'm sorry, I made a confused mistake. So, Cindy Francis and Linda, Lady Legionnaire, I believe that's her name, 13. So please, ladies, email me so that I can get these out to you. I really don't want you to lose out on getting your prize. And then this week, then the one I put up for last week, I chose the winners earlier this evening. And those were Lindy Stitch's Bloom Where You're Planted. And this, the winner of this one, the keyword was skunk. And the winner of this one is Laura T. Laura T, you have won Bloom Where You Were Planted. So please email me and send me your address, and I will get this out to you. Congratulations, Laura. And then the next one is Made Topography by Pine Mountain Designs. This is it. And the winner of that one, the keyword was flowers, and the winner of that one was Teresa Chuckle. So Teresa, you've won this topography. Made Topography, please email me, and I will get this out to you. All right, so moving on, plans. So I'm doing Mania, but I cannot do one every day. May, we have 5 more weeks of school. The first week of this month, we have open house. Then there's testing, and then there's planning kinder celebration. And then we send their little sweetie pies off to first grade. So it's a really, really busy month. So I can't do 31 starts, there's no way. And I can't do 22 because I still wouldn't make that goal. And I'd hate to set myself up for failure. So I am going to do what my friend Barbara suggested. And she said, well, if you want to participate, what if you did one project starting every Monday in May, and then you stitched it Monday through Friday, and then that way on the weekends you could still stitch the things that you've been wanting to stitch on, whether it be WIPCO or your bucket list or anything else that comes your way that you would like to start and don't want to feel like you can't because of Mania. And I said, well, that's a wonderful idea. I'm going to do it. So let me share with you what I'm going to start. All right. So the first one that I want to do, and my friend PJ stitching it, and she was teasing me, telling me I shouldn't finish it before her. I'm sorry, PJ. I'll stitch as quickly but and slowly as I can, I guess. I don't know how to say that, but so I'm going to do Stitching with the Housewives Home. I would like to get the H, M, and E finished. If I get the wreath finished too, that would be a bonus, but I'm not going to be upset if I don't, because I did purchase seasons one and seasons two, or swap one and swap two, sorry. Swap one and swap two. So if I only get the H, M, and E done, that's okay, because then I can begin doing the monthly ones. So that's my first one. I'll start that one. And I don't know what order I'm going to do tomorrow when I wake up. Whatever I'm feeling will be the one I start. And I'm just going to do that throughout the whole month. And then the next one I'm going to stitch for the next Monday or whatever Monday is Crow Alphabet Sampler by Frog Cottage Designs. And I think that's a small, so I should be able to get it done in a week's time. So I'm looking forward to doing that one. It's so pretty, and I really would like to stitch it. So then the next one, I became Teresa Kogut's Patreon member, and she put out, and I asked her if it's okay if I share. I plan on stitching this. This is for Patreon members, so if you're not one, maybe you should join, because she gives you some lovely designs throughout the entire month. I want to say I'm level 4, so I will get all of them, but for each month that she puts out, and she puts out coloring pages too. Plus, you get to see all kinds of stuff as she's working through it. So it's a really neat group to be a part of, and I feel like that's real well worth it. So last month for April, one of the charts she put out was called Strawberry Delight. This is it. I just think it's so gorgeous, and I'm hoping to get all of my stitching for June done with strawberries. That's what I would like to decorate, and I don't have any to start with, so this will be my very first one. So I chose this one, and I am going to stitch it on dark. The other ones, I haven't picked out the fabric yet. I'll share with you what fabrics in my next video that I did on the ones that I have started by the time I see you next time. But this one I know for sure I want to do it on black, because I think it really pops and is really pretty. So looking forward to doing that one. And then the next one I'm gonna do, this one is by Twin Peak Primitives. And if you go to their website, this is a freebie, and the freebie is Welcome. And I think it's so cute. Sorry, excuse me. As I said, those allergies are really bad. So I'm gonna stitch this one. I'm not sure what color fabric, but I love it. I love the little bird in the vine at the top. The sheep are cute, and I love weeping willow trees, and those are my favorite kind of trees. So I thought that was a cute pattern, and it's a freebie. So I just printed it out, and that's one I've been wanting to start, which is why I bought it. And then I was in Friend Stitch this year, or yeah, this year. I'm trying to think, was it this year or last year? No, I think it was this year. I might have been the end of last year. Well, anyways, I was in Friend Stitch, and one of the patterns that we got in Friend Stitch was an autumn gathering called Let Joy In. This is the pattern. And Friend Stitch, the pattern is made, it's a collaboration of Cecilia Turner and Bent Creek. So Heart and Hand and Bent Creek. They're two of the three people in the triology. So they get together and they do Friend Stitch. And it was a virtual retreat, so we did it from our computers, from our home. And this was the pattern. It came, everything that I needed to stitch it is in it. And I just haven't started it. And so it comes with vintage country mocha fabric. And I figured that what a great way to start. Do it now. And whatever I don't finish this summer when I get off for summer break, I can work on it and have it ready to display in the fall. So I'm excited about that. And then for plans, my birthday is next weekend. This year it falls on Mother's Day. Sometimes it does. Sometimes it's a couple days prior. But this year it does. And so I'm going to have a birthday start. I've never done a birthday start before. And I thought, why not? I'm doing mania. Might as well start one more. So I'm going to do Nevermore by Lila Studios. I know that I'm stitching it on Dusk, but I'm waiting for it to picture this plus Dusk, and I believe I picked 28 counts, so it's going to be quite big, but that's the fabric I chose. However, I don't have a local needle workshop, so I had to order online, so I'll make the final decision when the fabric gets here, because I've never purchased it before, and I'm not quite sure if it's going to look like it did in the little thumbnail on the computer. So hopefully, if it does, I'll be all set. I've also ordered the floss as well, so that's all on its way. So as soon as, hopefully, fingers crossed, I'm crossing my fingers a lot this time, hopefully this one will be all ready to go by next weekend so that I can begin it. I ordered from 123 Stitch, and they're usually pretty fast, so I'm expecting that I should have everything I need in the next day or two, so it should be okay. So this will be my birthday star. I love this pattern. Edgar Allan Poe is one of my favorite poets, and I can't wait to stitch this. I want to get it done for the fall as well. And then on the weekends, when I'm not doing mania, I am going to continue stitching. I started stitching ABC by Primrose Cottage. I know everybody's stitching these. I have enough fabric from the last piece in the Berkshire Hive to stitch it. So I started working on it, and I'm actually quite halfway there. It seems like such a big piece when you look at it here, but I'm stitching on 14 count, and this is like the halfway point. This is the whole one side of it, and I've already gotten that far. And it only took me, I think I spent 2 days on it, so it's pretty fast. So I hope to have that finished as well. And if I finish it, then I'll move on to Bumblebee Kisses, which I also have that one. So I'll have all three. I swapped my other pattern. What's it called? It just like floated out of my brain. Be Nice or Buzz Off. I've swapped that with my friend PJ, and she's giving me one of their other ones that matches along with this pattern too. So when she finishes stitching it, she's not quite done yet. So we're making a trade. And then I have WIPCO. Now WIPCO numbers that were called this month is Work in Progress Go, WIPCOs. So trying to get all your work in progress completed. They called WIPCOs numbers 8, 13, and 14. So I was kind of panicked because three numbers and then mania, and whoo, how am I going to get it done? But I'll get it done. So, or I'll at least give it my best shot. That's all I can do. So I have Adventure Awaits by Caterpillar Cross Stitch. After this WIPCO, I'll be finished with this piece. So here's where I am. All I have to finish is South America. Central and South America is what's left. That's it. And then I'll be finished with that, and I can frame it and get it up into my classroom in time for school next year. Because I don't think I'll have it framed this year. But over the summer, I should be able to frame it and get it into my classroom. So that one is one of them that was called. Then Plum Street had a free 12 Days of Christmas stitch along years ago. Sorry, I think I'm going to sneeze again. I'm so sorry. And I started it a long time ago. I think it was like 2008. I don't know. But this is what it's supposed to look like when it's finished. And I am on 9 ladies dancing, I believe. And so here's mine. And I will go down to here and start 9 ladies dancing. So that one, it will be finished after that, because of course we're not at 12 days yet. My next WIPCO project is by Shannon Christine, and it's from the 2021 Halloween Club. I was in that group of Halloween ornaments in July, and this is it. I'm working on Hocus Pocus. And this one I started the night my son's girlfriend went into the hospital to have my grandson. And so I got the call, I think, at 11 o'clock at night, and I was doing 24 hours of cross stitch. And so I had to stop 24 hours of cross stitch and get down to the hospital. I ended up sitting down there for 3 or 4 hours. As you know, first babies take a while. And it was a false alarm. So I came home to get some coffee and freshen up a little bit. And I ended up falling asleep, and I went back at 4 in the morning, and he came, I want to say, at 3 in the morning. So I missed him by 1 hour, but I was able to come back in at 4 in the morning and see him. So this is all I got in that hour. So I put it away because after that, the month of, or 24 hours of cross stitch was over, and I decided I'd work on it to get it done in time for this year's Halloween. So that's one of the whip goes that I need to finish. And after that, that'll be another fish. So if I get them done this month, that'll be 2 finishes off my WIP go list. That's a progress happening. And then my last thing that I want to get done is my other bucket list. My bucket list for me is to do one of the cubes or mattress finishes. I'm not sure which it's called, but I'm doing my daughter, Cassandra loves cats just like I do. And I asked her, I stitched a piece by Lizzie Kate for my other daughter, and she likes dogs, and it's a dog row, I believe, from Lizzie Kate. And I stitched that for her, and I asked Cassiana what she would like me to make for her, and there was a kitten row, but she didn't want the kitten row. She wanted this one, so I made it my bucket list. And this one is Meow from Block Party, hands-on design. And so I'm going to work on doing this for my bucket list. And then I can say that I've stitched one of the mattress finishes. So I will be doing that one too. So those are my other plans besides Mania. It's funny, you have big plans, I know. Hopefully I can meet some of those goals. Maybe not all of them, but I'm gonna try my best. We'll see how that goes. Also, I wanna bring an update for our swap update. Today is May 1st. I believe there was 7 plus me, so 8 people in our swap that has sent me their email or address and is ready to do swaps. Today, after this video, I am going to put together your partner. I'm going to send out their information. Remember that we're stitching something for summer, and the date to mail it off is June 1st, and it shouldn't be more than 6x6, and the theme is summer. So you choose something out of summer that you would like to stitch for you. You can finish it however you want. If you want to make an ornament, if you want to make a pillow, a flat fold, whatever you want to do for your partner, that's up to you. It's a lot of fun. In the beginning of my video, there was a Halloween piece in my video, and it was Boo by Puttini Puttini, and that is a freebie pattern, and that was the piece that I stitched for Nancy Haber. I know she's received it, and she said she loves it. She's at a quilting retreat this weekend, so I know that in their next floss tube, she's probably going to share it. So if you'd like to see it again, it is, Nancy is one half of the duo sisters in the Bougie Stitchers. And so she will probably be sharing it on her channel. So if you hop over to her channel on our next one, and make sure when you subscribe to both me and them, if you want to be notified when we put up a video, you have to click the bell. And so when you click on the bell, there's some choices. You want to pick up the top one, and the top one will give you a notification anytime we post anything. And then that way you know that it's there, ready for you to watch when you're ready. So that swap is on her. She's received it. I know that she was going to mail out one to me, but they got 18 feet, I believe is what she said, of snow. Or maybe it was 18 inches. I don't know. I could be wrong. But she got a lot of inches of snow because she sent me pictures. They were all snowed in. So it didn't get mailed out right away. And so that's fine. I will wait. And when I get it, I'll be happy to share what she sent. So check your email by tomorrow. I should have your email out with your partner so that you can get ready to send out something for summer for your partner. Next up is my giveaway for this week. So my giveaway for this week, I was thinking summer, As I said, 5 more weeks until summer break. I'm really looking forward to summer break. It's been a tough year teaching kindergarten when they were in COVID last year. Most of the children don't know how to relate to other adults. They came in not knowing how to relate with other children. It was really tough. And now we're a close-knit, happy family. And it's going to be sad. It's always sad every year when they have to go. And I have to get a new class, which I'm excited about. But it makes me sad to let them go because they mean so much to me. So, however, we've worked hard this year. And having that break is going to be nice to hang out with my family and do some things around the house. And maybe go on a few day trips. I loved all your weekend getaways. A lot of them sound interesting, and I did some Googling to see what the places you were talking about looks like, and I wish I could just zoom over to each one of them. They looked really nice and really relaxing. So this week, I'm going to give away Hands on Design, A Year in Chalk, and this one's June, and it says Catch a Wave. So this is the piece. And then the keyword for this one is wave. And then I have this one by Country Cottage Needleworks Summer Sampler. I stitched this last year, and this is it. And the keyword for this one is summer. So remember, keyword, if you like Catch a Wave, is wave, and the keyword for the summer sampler is summer. And I will pull those next week. Remember not to say giveaway, freebie, prize. Just say the keyword, and I will put that in the comment picker, and that's how I will choose my winner for next week. All right, and then my question that I would like you to answer so that you can be entered into the giveaway is, what is your favorite cross-stitch fabric color? Now, because I don't have a local needlework shop, I don't know what a lot of the fabrics look like. So I usually will go on 123 Stitch and order. I think they have a small piece of most of their fabrics, and it's like a 9x13. And sometimes I'll order that just to test it out and see if I like it. And then if I do, then I'll order a larger piece. But I would love to see what your favorites are. My favorite color fabric is Vintage Country Mocha. I stitch a lot on that. When I do Coffee Tea Dyed Monaco, they're very close in color as well. So I like that too. But if I was to pick one, that would be my most favorite color fabric. But I would love to hear what yours is. So share with me your favorite color fabric. And then I will see you again next week. But until I see you again, please remember to be confident, be courageous, be creative, and be kind. I hope you have a wonderful 2 weeks. Again, happy Mother's Day to all of those moms out there, even if you're a pet mom, because that counts too. And I hope you have a great 2 weeks, and I'll see you back here then. Bye.